Good morning, dear students. Let's start our English lesson. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Ayşan Basarbekovna and I'm your English teacher. So let's have a look at the board. Tell me please, how are you feeling now? So what concerns me? Today I feel happy because I have a lesson with you. So are you happy, surprised, dramatic, hungry, annoyed and so on? So, the topic of our today's lesson is the degrees of comparison of adjectives. So, as we know, an adjective has three degrees. It is positive, for example, high, positive, next, positive, superlative, positive, comparative, and superlative. For example, brave, braver, the bravest, big, bigger, the biggest, dirty, dirtier, the dirtiest. Yes. So expensive. The car is expensive. This car is more expensive. This car is most expensive. Next. So let's have a look at this table. As I said, our adjective has three types. Yeah. The first is positive. The next is comparative and the last is superlative degree. Let's have a look. So let's take an adjective low. So in order to compare it, we add the suffix er. For example, low, lower. And to make superlative degree, we add suffix est. For example, low, lower, the lowest. So next, what concerns complex adjectives? So it has two syllables, pretty. We have to, if the adjective is ended in y, we have to put I instead of y, yes? For example, pretty, prettier, the prettiest. So the next one, what concerns complex adjectives, it has three syllables. We should add the word more in comparative degree and in superlative, the word most. For example, modern, more modern, the most modern. So let's practice the first exercise. Fill in the blanks with the correct comparative and superlative degrees of following adjectives. For example, hard, harder, the hardest. The next, fill in the blanks with the correct comparative and superlative degrees of following adjectives. Next. This exercise also for comparative form of adjectives. Write the superlative form of the adjectives. For example, I'm the tallest in the class. Yes. In this exercise, you have to insert comparative or superlative form of the adjectives. In this exercise, compare the mobile phones. Compare the people. Exercise 5. Read the poem, learn it and find in the poem adjectives just for you. You should to learn this by heart. Task 7. Complete the sentences using comparative or superlative form of degrees of comparison. And the last is test for you. Test yourself, please. The next topic of our today's lesson is types of houses. So first of all, let's have a look at the main types of English houses. Next. The first, first of all, I want you to learn vocabulary on this topic. The first, a block of flats. What is? A flat is a part of a bigger building where all the flats share a front door. A detached house. A detached house is not joined to any other houses. A semi-detached house, what is it? It is a house which is joined to another house on one side. The next, a tourist house is a house which is part of a line of houses. It is a house which is a mansion. A mansion is a large and impressive house, the large house of a wealthy person. A cottage. A cottage is a small house, usually of only one story. It is a small, modest house at a lake mountain resort. A caravan. is a vehicle equipped for living in, typically to wet. So a farmhouse is a house attached to a farm, especially the dwelling. A hut is a small or humble dwelling of simple construction, especially made of natural materials. A bungalow is a house that usually has only one story. A skyscraper is a very tall building with many stories. A chalet is a small wooden house, especially in a mountain area or a holiday camp. So, these were our vocabulary, new words. You should read this text, find out new words, and translate it. Thank you for your attention.